Welcome to Control-M's Self-Conversion Overview video. In this video, you will learn why you would use Control-M Self-Conversion, how to get it, and how you would use it to develop new conversions. Running your business flow through Control-M gives you a single point of control, visibility, and security. In addition, you can see predictive alerts in case of future problems. Therefore, many customers want to bring their automation silos into Control-M. Control-M Self-Conversion enables you to consolidate automation silos from any scheduler, business application, or homegrown application and converts them into Control-M job flows. You can also use it to convert data into your own Control-M application integrated job types. To start Control-M Self-Conversion, download the conversion tool zip file from ftp.bmc.com. After you have extracted the zip file, double-click the self-conversion batch file to launch the application. If you want to use one of the existing built-in conversion engines, such as Crone, CA Atomic, Tidal, and so on, click the conversion batch file to launch the conversion tool. Before creating a conversion using Control-M Self-Conversion, you need to do the following. Extract the input data that you want to convert to Control-M into an XML format. Data contained in JSON, CSV, Excel, or other formats can easily be converted into XML using free web tools. For example, open any web browser and search for Convert CSV to XML. Remember, if you need assistance, you can always contact BMC support. You also need to understand the mapping logic between the input data and Control-M folders and jobs. You need to know what should be converted to Control-M job, folder, and so on. In this example, we can see the following. The box XML element will be mapped to a smart folder. The box name XML attribute value will be mapped to a smart folder name. The job XML element will be mapped to a job. And the name attribute value will be mapped to a job name. Now, let's open Control-M Self-Conversion and you will see the home page. In the bottom half of the screen, you can see the project repository, which enables you to view and or edit existing projects. By default, self-conversion comes with a sample project that contains rules examples that use GroovyScript and Conversion API on top of sample data. You can review these rules to understand how Conversion API is being used to create Control-M data. Conversion Rules Repository is where you can view, edit, or export existing conversion rules or import new ones. In the top half of the screen, you can see the fields that need to be completed to create a new conversion project. Let's start a new conversion project. Let's add the name of the project. Select the input data that you want to convert to Control-M. It can be a single file or directory containing many files. Let's add the folder. Specify the target Control-M version that you want to convert to. We'll use V918. Add the name of the vendor that you're converting from. If you have already created conversion rules, you can add them here. Add a project description. Click Create Project, and you'll see the project created successfully. Now, the conversion rules definition window appears, which consists of the following areas. In the middle, you can see the input data that you want to convert to Control-M. On the right, you can see all the input data files that have been imported. If you want to review a different file, just click on it. At the top, you can see the conversion rules category tabs that guide you through the flow for creating conversion rules. When clicking on a conversion rule category tab, you can see in the left-hand pane the mandatory conversion rules you need to define for each category. If you want to set rules for additional Control-M folder attributes, click the plus sign and from the drop-down list, select the attributes that you want to add. Click Save to add them. When you click on a rule in the left-hand pane, you can edit the rule in the bottom rules editor pane. In this pane, you can create the rule using two modes, graphical or script mode. The graphical mode enables you to create simple rules that can be described using a graphical statement. Now, let's create some rules. In the folder tab, let's create a folder from every element that equals box. Let's also set the folder name according to the value of attribute box underscore name. Go through each category tab and add rules as necessary. For example, in the job tab, you can see we've added create a controller job, which equals job, and job name equals name. In the hierarchy category tab, we need to specify how to link jobs to folders. If we need to create a multi-hierarchy, we need to define how to link folders to folders. The second mode is the script mode, which is where all the magic happens. The script mode enables you to create more sophisticated conversion rules using Groovy scripting language and self-conversion API. Groovy is a Java syntax-compatible, object-oriented programming language that can be used as a script language and used widely in many tools such as Jenkins. Let's look at Control-M Self-Conversion API in a little more detail. Control-M Self-Conversion API enables you to create Control-M data, folders and jobs, retrieve data from XML, our input data format. There are three API classes that are used to create Control-M data. CTM job, that exposes API to define and retrieve Control-M job attributes. Control-M folder, which exposes API to define and retrieve Control-M folder attributes. Control-M workspace, which exposes API to define and retrieve Control-M folders, jobs, and flows. There are two classes, which exposes API to retrieve data from your input data. Control-M XML element, which exposes API to retrieve data from the XML element, and CTM XML query, which exposes API to retrieve XML data from the XML document. In the Control-M self-conversion documentation, we have many code examples demonstrating how to use Conversion API together with Groovy to create Control-M data. You can use this as a sample for creating your own specific rules. Let's go back to self-conversion. To edit a rule in script mode, click Edit Script. You'll see a confirmation message which states that by switching to script mode, the graphical mode of this specific rule will be disabled. You can always go back to graphical mode by disguising the changes in the script mode. You can now edit the script as you wish. The changes will be automatically saved. After you finish the script, you can test that the syntax of the rule is correct by clicking Test Rule Syntax. You can also verify that the rule creates the Control-M data as expected by clicking Test Rule Functionality. Let's test the Create Folder rule. We can see that running this rule, two folders will be created. At any point during the conversion rules creation process, you can click Run to see the conversion results. So let's now run the conversion. The Conversion Results tab appears. At the top of the screen, you can see the status of the conversion, which completed successfully. If there were errors, the status will be in red together with the error message. In case of warnings, the status will be in orange and will contain a list of warnings in the bottom part, with links to the specific rules that need correcting. Underneath the status, we can see the created Control-M data in XML format. You can review the data that has been created for verification. For example, look for a specific job and verify that it contains the expected attributes. In the bottom half of the screen, you can see a high-level summary of all Control-M entities created, such as folders, jobs, and job types. If you need to improve the conversion results, go back to any of the tabs and change any rules you require, then rerun the conversion. When you are satisfied with the results, you can save the rules for future projects by clicking Save as Rules. Add a name and description and click Save. To view the results in Control-M Client, firstly click Results and then select either Show in Folder, Copy Path to Clipboard. Then open Control-M Client and import the Control-M data file created by self-conversion. In Control-M Client, you can continue to verify the results and do additional adjustments using the Find and Update tool. This now concludes the video. For more information about Control-M self-conversion, click Help from the application to view the Control-M Self-Conversion online help.